In order to understand screen resolutions, we must first of all understand pixels. Consider pixels as tiny block of cells that make up a screen. Each cell can produce one color combination at a time with the aid of a graphic or image processor. And the combination of all these pixels displaying various colors at the same time forms the image you see on the screen. The smaller the pixels you have on the screen, the clearer the image would appear to be. Pixels are square-shaped, so even angular lines and curved edges you see on the screen are not entirely smooth. On a closer look, they are more like piled-up bricks. But you couldn't tell until now because of how tiny the pixels are. For this reason, manufacturers have been obsessed with making these pixels smaller. That brings us to screen resolutions. Screen resolution is the number of pixels that make up the width of the display times the number of pixels that make up the length of the display. This concept is what gave rise to SD, HD, FHD, QHD, 4K UHD, and 8K UHD. SD means standard definition and has about 720 pixels in its length and about 480 pixels arranged in its width. That means such TV can conveniently play content labeled 480p on full screen. HD means high definition and has a total of 1280 pixels arranged horizontally and 720 pixels on the vertical side of the screen. Whenever you see HD or HDTV on a TV product, that means the TV can conveniently play and stream any content labeled 720p on full screen because the content, which could be a video or image, would match the TV screen pixel for pixel. FHD means full high definition. When you see FHD on a TV product, that tells you the TV has a total of 1920 pixels arranged on the length and 1080 pixels arranged on the width. That means this TV screen can play any content, whether image or video, labeled 1080p or FHD on full screen by matching pixel for pixel. 2K HD or QHD means quad high definition. Quad means 4, which tells you one QHD display is as big as 4 HD displays, thus the name QHD. When you see QHD or 2K on a TV product, it means the display has a total of 1,152 pixels arranged vertically and 2,048 pixels arranged horizontally on the screen. The term 2K means 2,000 pixels, which is the approximate number of pixels on the horizontal side of the screen. That means if you were to play or stream a content labeled 2K, you can enjoy a full screen with no quality loss, because the number of pixels the video has would match the number of pixels the TV screen has. UHD means ultra high definition and is available in 4K and 8K. 4K UHD means 4000 pixels ultra high definition. When you see 4K on any TV product, it means there are approximately 4000 pixels, which should be about 4096 pixels, arranged on the horizontal side of the display and about 2304 pixels arranged on the vertical side of the screen. While an 8K UHD content would arrange approximately 8000 pixels, which should be about 7680 pixels on the horizontal side of the display and about 4320 pixels on the vertical side of the display, and would play 8K content on full screen swimmingly. By multiplying the number of pixels on the vertical side of a display by that on the horizontal side of the display, you can easily know the total number of pixels any TV has. Also know the difference between screen resolution and screen size. Screen size measures the overall size of the TV from one edge to the other, while screen resolution tells you the number of pixels by stating the number of pixels on the horizontal side and the number of pixels on the vertical side, on which when multiplied would give you the total number of pixels. This is why a 32-inch TV can have a 4K resolution, and a 72-inch TV can also have a 4K resolution. Even a 100-inch TV can also have a 4K resolution. This tells you that these three TVs may have different sizes, but they have the exact same number of pixels. The only difference would be the pixel size and the pixel spacing. The distance between each pixels might be slightly wider on the bigger TVs. So a 4K 32-inch TV would give you a clearer image compared to a 72-inch 4K TV because of the pixel size, but the number of pixels are basically the same. This is why larger TVs would feature 8K resolution, but a 72-inch 4K TV having bigger pixels might not be noticeable because of the viewing distance. Bigger TVs are usually viewed from a farther distance. In terms of image quality, well, you'd hurriedly say 8K since it has the largest number of pixels and would display more image details. But what if you were to play or stream smaller content like 4K or HD videos? Well, two things would happen. You'd see a blank black frame around your TV telling you, hey, there are too many pixels here and we're just all idle. The TV would basically allocate the number of pixels needed to match the video, making it appear really tiny. But thanks to modern technology, the TV can take at least 4 pixels or 8 pixels each and make them act like 1 pixel. In order to occupy the screen and perhaps help you deceive yourself that you're watching an 8K content. A process known as upscaling. The result is a less sharp image quality, and since most platforms like YouTube Prime Video and even cable satellite decoder still stream below 4K, a UHD TV might create a picture quality nightmare for you. 4K TVs are preferable since platforms like YouTube and Netflix now offer most content on 4K. You definitely survive, but nevertheless, majority of the content available today are in 1080p. Max resolution. In terms of cost, the QHDs and the HDs would give a good experience if you're budget conscious. Let me explain. If you have a QHD or HD TV, you can stream virtually every content as most videos and movies in general are available for streaming in HD or 1080p, even though they were shot in 4K or 8K. That means you can still enjoy full screen resolution content and save cost on data traffic, decoder subscription. Even the decoder you get to buy doesn't have to be premium. You even get to save cost on electricity bills because it takes more energy to process 4K and 8K resolution content, especially when streaming. 4K seems to be the bridge between both worlds, as upscaling HD to 4K doesn't produce such a bad image quality after all. A 4K TV can't play 8K content without the help of special processing, so that's sort of a limitation. 8K TVs are only good for one reason. If technologies like 5G is fully developed and content creators and producers start filming and streaming in 8K in the nearest future, you wouldn't need to get a new TV. A concept most people prefer to call future-proofing. That is, getting a device capable of handling future innovations before they get in vogue. But for a simple person looking for a great TV to buy without being out of date, buy 4K UHD TV or 2K QHD TV. But if you want to stay in the safety zone where you don't want to increase your expenses on data, premium subscriptions, power consumption, or maybe you have an entry-level decoder like GoTV and the likes, a HD or QHD TV would serve you well. Anything higher would require massive upscaling, and the result is a blurry image. Now that you know these things, you can go ahead and buy a TV. Give us a like, also check out the description for links to the TVs we recommend for rich screen resolution. That way you also get to support the channel. It's your free advice consultant, Justin. Bye bye.